It is day three of the Hong Kong trip. Today the start is already great because it's not raining. It's actually sunny, unlike yesterday. To be honest, yesterday was great too. Considering that it was raining on and off all day, like we really did make the most out of it. Today we're going to go to Macau. We do have a rough plan of what we're gonna do in Macau, but my friend also doesn't really know how to get around in Macau, so I'm a little worried, but hopefully we'll make the most out of it. Are you guys ready for last day in Hong Kong? Let's go to Macau together. I know I mentioned so many times how humid Hong Kong is, but I'm still amazed at how humid it is. Cause guys, I'm wearing nothing. I usually don't put on like foundation or whatever. I need stuff on my skin, but I usually put blush and like eyeliner, but I have nothing right now. I don't even have lotion or moisturizer on. I literally just have sunscreen on and it's fine. If I lived in Hong Kong, I would save so much money on skincare. Because the humidity does it all for me.
Now that our bellies are full, are you ready to go to Macau? Let's go.
All right, so let me explain this as simple as possible. Firstly, you have to bring your passport because you go through immigration to get to Macau. Secondly, I recommend you check out this site for the ferry time. Thirdly, there are two terminals in Macau, Outer Harbor Ferry Terminal and Tai Pa Ferry Terminal. People recommend Outer Harbor because it's closer to the city, but I got off at Tai Pa and it was honestly fine for me. We got on a taxi that was like a 10-minute ride to the city, so if you don't mind, Tai Pa is cool too. Fourthly, buy data or phone service package that is specifically for Macau because Hong Kong ones don't work there. Lastly, Octopus card doesn't work there either, so bring Hong Kong cash or exchange to Macau currency. We went to Tsing Wan Station exit D to Shin Tak Center to get on the ferry. We got there by 11:20 to get on the 11:30 ferry, thinking that we could get tickets right away, but the time was closed for 11:30 ferry. We got lucky because there were these random men selling 11:30 tickets, but I recommend you go at least 30 minutes earlier than your ferry time for your tickets. Or you can wing it like us and pray that these random men will come save your day. The whole place kind of looks like an airport with immigration and gate numbers, but yeah, once you get through, hand in your ticket to the supervisors in front of your gate to get your seat number. After an hour ride, we got off at Tai Pa Ferry Terminal. You go through immigration again, so don't be surprised if you're stuck in a long line. We looked around to buy return tickets in advance, but there were no ticket booths for some reason. So we decided to wing it and left. But if you want to be more responsible, apparently the ticket booths were at the front of the building. You have to walk a long way from the arrival gate, but do as you please. Again, we got lucky and got return tickets 5 minutes before departure. We had to run to get to the gate, but we safely made it. And just FYI, luck is usually never on my side, and I hate doing things spontaneously, but on this day, surprisingly, everything worked out for me, so it was a great adventure. Hope this was helpful. Good luck.
Sao Paulo.
Ay, ay, ay.
Where to next? Wow, for the first time I see you. Airport I've ever seen. To mainland China? Oh my gosh, imagine if we go to China, bro. Ooh. 5 minutes left, we made it.
We made it on time.
Okay. How many steps? Can you say that one more time?
This was my best trip ever.
Rate our trip, our hangout.
Six?
10 out of 10.
Yeah. Why? Because it was really good. Destination is
food.
Mmm. Yeah.
Ooh. It's awesome. I didn't really like that one.
Like
yeah, especially that hotel. Just walking on the local street. Honestly, like watching movies here was fun too.
Guys, watch Fall Guy.
This was really good.
Good.
Oh my god.